What's going on, guys? Jeremy Popman here, IFBB Men's Physique Pro, HD Muscle, and Team Dark Sport Athlete. Today is back day, so I want to take you guys through that, show you guys what I do. A lot of rolling movements, of course, row to grow, get that back density. Show you a few tips and tricks to help build out that width as well by targeting your teres muscle group. Just a few things I've learned over the years from various people, but yeah, guys, tag along and let's get it. All right, guys, so for the first exercise, what we're gonna be doing, don't quite know the name to it, something I learned from an acquaintance of mine, Phil Viz. This is gonna help target your teres muscle group, so back here, which is gonna help push everything out. Again, it's one of those exercises not a lot of people think about, especially when targeting your lats. You always think lat pull-downs for width. But if you can push out those lats, delts, why not? So what you're doing right here, neutral grip, kind of shake things over, get a good position where you're stretching out your lats and you're just pulling down, contracting with that teres muscle group. And the key here is to keep your elbows tight, especially on that right here at this motion when you're down. And here we're doing about 4 sets of 20. So this, again, you feel it. If you're doing it right, you're gonna feel everything right here, kind of nice stretch, nice and tight. But yeah, just keep watching, see if you can pick it up, see exactly what I'm doing, and just kind of mirror it or mimic it. All right, guys, so right after those, again, target the teres muscle group, don't know what to call them, go straight to pullovers, cable pullovers. The main focus here, again, is not to incorporate the lower part of your back, but to keep it isolated so you're hitting just your lats, your teres, and all that. So just to show you what I'm talking about. So by doing this, I'm keeping all my lower back out of it. It's not like your typical that you see a lot of people doing. Very strict and very focused on one area of your back. Whew. That's gonna help with that width, guys. All right, guys, here we're just doing a normal pull down, more of a pronated grip. You're gonna focus a lot more on the back contraction. You do feel it with this mag bar, a little bit more to your mid, lower lat, rhomboid area. So it's a very nice squeeze, very nice warm up exercise. Do a few of these before we get into the working set. All right, guys, up next is a T-bar row variation. We are gonna be targeting upper back here. So here, instead of doing a straight grip, we are gonna go a little neutral. Nothing too fancy about it. Just kind of get a full squeeze up at the top. Don't jerk the weight around like you're not supposed to. Try to keep form as possible, as clean as possible, but other than that, just watch how it's done.
you arguably have one of the best backs in the league, but you think it's one of the muscle groups that you have to improve on.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Because, I mean, that's the name of the game here, is constant progression, constant improvement. Everybody's working hard. And if you, for 1 second, think that you have a leg up on anybody, that's when you fucking slip up. That's when they pass you, because they're gonna be working 10 times harder than you are. So you can't let up. Can't let up one single bit. You know, just like my ginormous calves, you know, I'm training those all the time because nobody can pass me. Not even Flex Lewis. No, but yeah, seriously though, guys, if you think one body part is better than another, don't stop training that shit. Like I said, there's always gonna be a guy that's hungrier. There's always gonna be a guy that, you know, has a statement to make. And all he sees is you're just another obstacle in his path. So stay consistent, stay intense, keep working, don't let up. Fucking, you'll get where you wanna get, guys. Just gotta keep with it, don't get comfortable. All right, guys, next up we are doing bent over barbell rows. We are doing it on a Smith machine. I do prefer that way. I keep the same path. Bar stays in the same path, so I do prefer it that way. Again, wearing a belt due to lower back issues, using my grips to keep my grip strength so I can focus on my back versus focus on my forearms or anything like that. Nothing too fancy with these guys. Just make sure you're going at it with intensity and with good form. That way you're targeting the right muscles. Alright, guys, next we are doing V-bar pull downs. There's several different ways you can target this. I'll show you both. Depends on how sloppy you want to get, how ugly you want to get. I like to personally do the grip where the handle's kind of facing, the far part's facing towards you. So what you can do is you can pull it away from your body, keep your body straight up. You're gonna end up targeting a lot of your lower lat, kind of where that Christmas tree part of your back is. Or you can just get sloppy with it, lean into it, and target more of your upper back. I guess it's not so focused on one general area. That's one way, and I'll show you guys the sloppy way on my next set. By no means am I an expert at anything, or do I claim to know everything. This is all stuff that I've learned through trial and error, working out throughout the years, training with other people, reading, studying. So like everything I do, my approach to training is something I've kind of put together with my knowledge of everything I've learned throughout the years. So again, guys, if there's something that I may be wrong in or something you guys feel is incorrect, feel free to comment, leave a message, let me know, because truth is, man, you should always be learning. You should be learning every single fucking day you're in the gym. Never feel like you know everything, because that can be the first one, the truth. Always something to learn, guys. That's just what it is. All right, guys. Next, we are doing a seated row, machine row. This pad feels like a fucking rock, so it sucks. I'm trying to figure out a nice way of adjusting myself accordingly so I'm not digging into my sternum too much. But the main thing here is keep your butt far back, keep your chest high, and that way, as you're pulling back, you can squeeze even a little bit more in that motion. And the thing I love about doing machine movements like this, if you see what I'm doing, I am pulling with my back first before I incorporate anything from my arms or my biceps. So motion, again, is all back, squeezing as much as I can with my back, then my arms playing a role, give you that extra little bit. That is why I do feel a lot of people like doing free weights, because honestly, it's more ego than anything. But you find a machine that hits everything really good and perfectly in the way you want to, fucking use it. That's what the machines are for.
You suck until it comes out.
You suck until it comes out. You heard it first.
I think that's not my job. Wait.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
There you go.
Alright guys, so that is a wrap for our day one back day. We have a second back day coming up later on in the week. Whatever we didn't hit, whatever important movements, we're gonna hit again on the next one. Again, just like any other time, I hope you guys learned something, took away a little few some tricks and tips. Again, in the comments, let me know what you guys think, what I can improve on, what you guys want to see, and we'll continue to go from there. Till next time, guys.